Hello, friends, and welcome to Virtual Storytime at the Chippewa River District Library. Will you join me in singing the hello song? Hello, friends. Hello, friends. Hello, friends. It's time to say hello. Welcome to the library. Today we are going to be talking all about rockets. And I have a very special book about a real life astronaut who used a rocket to go into space. Are you ready to hear it? This is May Among the Stars by Rhoda Ahmed, and it is the real life story of a real life astronaut, Dr. Mae Jemison. Here is our title page. We have the title, May Among the Stars. And then the author and illustrator down here, we have Rhoda Ahmed, who is the author, and Stasha Burrington, the illustrator. We also have this gorgeous picture. Look, here's little May, the main character who is based on Dr. Mae Jemison. And we also have a rocket. Looks like she's gonna take that rocket to go into space. Little May was a dreamer. They say that daydreamers never succeed, but little May was different. One day, May was working on an assignment for school about what she wanted to be when she grew up. What will you tell them, May?
I will tell them I want to see Earth.
But this is Earth, May, said her mother. The flowers, the grass, the forest, and the mountains, we live on Earth.
I know. But I want to see Earth from out there.
That's an amazing plan, little May. Then you have to become an astronaut. That way you can see Earth from space.
An astronaut? Do you think I could do that?
What do you think, friends? Do you think she can become an astronaut?
Of course you can. If you can dream it, if you can believe it and work hard for it, anything is possible.
May asked her mom to take her to the library. She searched for books about space and astronauts. There she is. She's lifting almost on the tippy-top shelf to find a book. And whoa, she's filled up her whole wagon full of books.
After dinner, May drew pictures of space, and she even made her own astronaut costume out of old orange curtains and cardboard boxes.
Oh yeah, it looks like she's made a rocket, and there's some pictures back there of the rocket and the solar system and a picture of May. Whoa, really cool.
To find out what happens to May at the end of this book, you can check it out from the library. I'll put a link in the description below so you can check this book out from our library, as well as a link to browse lots of other awesome books about space.
So just like May went to the moon, we're gonna go to the moon too. Will you join me as we sing a song about going to the moon? First, I'm gonna teach you some motions. For zoom, 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 we're gonna go like this. Can you zoom, zoom, zoom with me? There you go, zoom, zoom, zoom. Then we're gonna climb aboard our rocket ship. Are you ready? Climb aboard. And finally, we're gonna blast off by jumping in the air. Blast off. Good job. Let's put it all together in the song. Zoom, 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 we're going to the moon. Zoom, 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 we're going to the moon. If you want to take a trip, climb aboard my rocket ship. Zoom, 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 we're going to the moon. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, blast off, jump! Good job, friends. Thank you for singing that song with me. We've zoomed to the moon, and now it's time to write about it. So grab a pencil, or you can just use your finger if you want to follow along writing in the air. We're going to do some tracing. Remember that any attempt is a good attempt when you're practicing your pre-writing skills. So feel free to follow along. Even if you can't get the letters perfect, you're still practicing, which is great. Let's start with this first capital letter. There's my capital Z. Next, we're going to go for a big circle. That's my O. Another big circle. Two O's in a row. And lastly, an M. Z, O, O, M. Z, oom. Zoom. It's time for a magnet board story. This story is called Five Little Rockets. And while we sing this story together, I'm going to display my five little rockets on my magnet board. The song starts out in space with one little rocket. What color is that rocket? Green, you're right. One little rocket went out to play in the Milky Way one day. She had such enormous fun. She called for another little rocket to come. Ooh, what color is this rocket? It's red. Now there are two rockets, the green one and the red one. Two little rockets went out one day in the Milky Way to play. They had such enormous fun that they called for another little rocket to come. This rocket is purple. And now we have one, two, three rockets. Three little rockets went out one day in the Milky Way to play. They had such enormous fun that they called for another little rocket to come. This rocket is what color? It's yellow. Now we have one, two, three, four rockets. Four little rockets went out one day in the Milky Way to play. They had such enormous fun that they called for another little rocket to come. What color is this last rocket? He's blue, isn't he? Yes, now we have one, two, three, four, five rockets. I think these rockets need to blast off into space. Can we count down from five and have a big blast off? Count with me, ready? Five, four, three, two, one, blast off! Awesome job, friends. Thank you for doing that song and magnet board with me. It's time for my favorite part of the program, yes or no trivia. I'm going to ask you three yes or no questions, and I want you to tell me either yes, the answer is yes, or thumbs down, the answer is no.
Okay.
First question, are rockets man-made vehicles? The answer is yes. Humans invented rockets as a way to put things up in space. A rocket uses a big engine that thrusts the rocket way up high up in the air during the blast off. Question two. Were the first rockets invented over 800 years ago? 800 years, that's a long time ago. Do you think that we've had rockets for 800 years? The answer is yes, we have had some form of rocket for over 800 years. The first rockets were used in medieval China to send fireworks up into space. Last question. Were humans the first beings to be sent into space on a rocket? What do you think? The answer is no. Humans were not the first beings to be sent into space. Before we sent humans into space, we sent monkeys
and dogs into space. They were the first astronauts. They even had their own spacesuits. Good job, friends. Did you get all the questions right? Thank you so much for playing trivia with me. Well, we've come to the end of our program today, and it is time to say goodbye. Will you sing with me? Goodbye, friends. Goodbye, friends. Goodbye, friends. It's time to say goodbye.